A viewer wrote to me today and asked me a question about heaven. So it was a very interesting question, and I thought you guys might like to hear what I have to say about it as well. It has to do with Christianity and Christian heaven. And if you're an ex-Christian or you've left the fold, so to speak, and you have questions like this, this might be of interest to you. He says, "Hello, Rich. In some of your videos, you mentioned we are like genies in the afterlife. You mentioned that we have infinite powers and can do anything, and we are like ascended masters to some of the inhabitants of the afterlife." Yep, I said that. If we have infinite power, if I went to the Christian heaven, will I be able to leave whenever I want and go to the other realms, or will I be trapped there? Thanks, Rich. Well, thank you for asking the question. And this just came in this morning too, by the way. Here's the deal, right? There are many versions of Christian heaven. These are realms, they're belief system territories created with the imagination of those that believe in that construct, in that reality. So you might have a lot of Pentecostals going to a Pentecostal Christian heaven. You might have some Southern Baptists going to a different version. It's a different belief system territory. Different people are there, but they all believe the Southern Baptists. And if you got this kind of Latter-day Saints over here, but you have different versions even within that, that is possible, because what this is really about is people going into another reality system when they leave here. And a lot of people will gravitate toward a belief system territory that matches their belief systems. There may be a few things off here and there, but generally that's where they will go, and they will fit in, and it'll be with people like them believing what they believe as regards Christianity and heaven and the Bible and all of that. Okay? So the question is, will you be like an ascended master, or will you like a genie out of the bottle where you can do all kinds of things? Now, that depends on each person individually. If you are of the mindset and you believe in yourself and you believe in the constructs of reality and the multidimensionality of reality in this way, where you are a traveler in the multiverse, explorer of the multiverse, and you're a free being, and you can go here and here and here and here. With that said, you can go to some realms where you can levitate things, walk through the walls, put your hand through the wall, fly, and things like this, where the locals cannot do that. So you would appear to them like somebody, wow, magical. From your perspective, you might feel like, oh, this is just an out-of-body experience and I'm flying around. Or you might be in a lucid dream where you start realizing, oh, I'm dreaming, which means you became aware that this is a construct that you are not limited by, because it's all in the mind. It's all in the imagination. So now, with your imagination, in your lucid dream, you can start flying. You may be able to change objects, change a car into a horse, or, you know, the environment changes, shifts from wintertime to summertime with a thought. Now, these ascended master abilities depend on your understanding of yourself and your abilities and the realm you are in, okay? So, you could be in either a lucid dream heaven world, of, let's say, the kind of heaven, like a Christian world that you believe in now, or you believe would be the Christian heaven of the people that believe in the Christian version that you do or did. So if you were to go to that kind of Christian heaven, you may or may not see angels, depends on what you believe. You may or may not see Jesus and God and the different things. It depends on the belief system of that religion and your personal beliefs regarding that belief system. Does that make sense? So you get that together, and then you will find yourself in one of those realms. And people do this all the time. They end up in a heaven world. But this heaven world is not necessarily like this heaven world. Then you've got Valhalla, you've got Paradise, you've got Shambhala, and other names for these afterlife realms. So everybody goes to their own place. Now, the part about being trapped or not trapped, that's the same as when you're in an out-of-body experience, and you carry with yourself some belief systems about yourself, and there's beliefs about the realm you're in. And so oftentimes you can fly and do things like that, but sometimes you'll be in a place where you can't fly. Sometimes you'll be in a place where you can levitate other objects, and sometimes you won't be able to. It'll have to do with how rock solid that belief system is, and then how much you have blended with or merged with or agreed to that belief system, which just looks like, you know, a big city or a countryside or a village or you're on a spaceship or something. Those realms, those reality systems, are all built with the imagination, yours and those other people. And then you have, how much are you agreeing with the others in that realm that this is what it is, and that you can't change this? You can't change the tree in town square, the big, giant, beautiful tree, into a marble statue. In some realms. In other realms, you can. And in other realms where you can change it, you go, good, it's a beautiful marble statue. And you come back a little bit later and it's a fountain. Somebody else has changed it yet again. So it's like that. Or do you go into a realm where the rule is, the agreements are that this is what the town looks like, we all agree, we don't change anything unless there's a group consensus to change it. So you can't walk in and just change the giant beautiful tree into a marble statue. Can't do it. So you walk in there and you've agreed before you do it subconsciously before you go into these realms and wake up in a non-physical reality. Go, ooh. And you don't even know what you've agreed to or not. It's kind of subconscious and automatic. And you try to change something in that environment and you can't change it. Okay, so can you leave there once you're there? If you understand and believe that there are many different versions of heaven and many different realms of existence and planes of existence, and you have practiced or you've gotten familiar with as a mindset and a belief system that you can move out of these places and get out of these, you shift consciousness. You don't have to really fly away from these places. You just shift your consciousness. It's like right now, some people have very vivid imaginations, right? And they can close their eyes and they can imagine a heaven world or any peaceful realm, non-physical, not here, but they see it around themselves. And then they can literally step into it. It's 360, it's all around them. Now they're experiencing in consciousness this other realm. And I've talked to many people that do this. And it's touchy-feely, and it's experiential and visceral, and it's like, I'm here. But they can change it. They can step out of it. They are not trapped in it. Now, other people can be in this physical world, and because of the beliefs held by the individual, they can feel trapped in the physical world. They can't get out of their body, and they can't get out of the physical dimensional plane, the physical reality, third density physical reality. They can't get out of that either. It's because of their beliefs. And we agree to believe things. So it has to do with what our agreements are. And there can be deep and they can be subconscious, both the beliefs and the agreements to believe it. So some people will go to a heaven world after here. They'll just gravitate to the heaven world of their default belief system. And they, oh, look, here I am. I'm in, and everything's right. It's like, yep. This is the one. But you know what? I don't believe in this really anymore. I'm out of here. Now, are you trapped? Only if you believe you could be trapped. Because, in fact, you can just leave. But you don't want to drop dead believing that in a particular heaven, you don't believe you're going to go to hell or purgatory or some other religious belief place. You're going to go into the heaven. But now you have an idea and a construct of what that heaven is. Now, do you, from here, go into there believing that that's it? I go to heaven, I'm stuck in heaven, I can't get out of heaven. If you believe that, then yeah, once you get there and you're feeling trapped, you're going to have to work on your beliefs about being trapped. It's quite simple, really, though. Just like here in the physical world, you may believe that you're stuck in your body and you can't get out of body, and lots of different reasons, and you've tried to get out of body and astral travel and you can't do it. Well, it's all based on beliefs and agreements and fears and thoughts and your own imagination and decisions you've made, things like this. So it's all internal. So you have to do your inner work here, and sometimes you got to do a lot of it to get out of body here. But then you can shift and get out of body from having been trapped. Same over there. If you're in a heaven world or someplace and you go, whoa, I want out of here. How do I get out of here? It's going to be about your own beliefs and your own imagination. Using your imagination, it's very powerful, like a genie out of a bottle. It's just whatever you can imagine will manifest. If you don't believe that, you have to practice releasing those limiting beliefs, spotting those limiting beliefs, and then releasing them. So that when you do get yourself into a heaven world, I just wanted to check it out. I want to see, you know, some relatives and loved ones. I'm pretty sure they came to this heaven world. I wanted to see them before I go on my merry way. Yeah, you can do that. So you don't have to worry about that. But these are some of the factors and considerations involved. If you have problems with this stuff, learn how to get out of body and also learn how to do emotional release work and learn how to release limiting beliefs. Those are the big ones. And also agreements, soul contract agreements, big. So learn how to do soul contract release work as well. So that's the sort of things I've done. And I've been into a lot of different realms and reality systems and belief system territories over the years. And not trapped in them. And I don't think you will be either. Just pay attention and keep learning while you're here how it all works. All right? Okay. Thanks for watching. And thanks for asking. You know who you are who asked. Okay? Thank you. Hope this helps. Bye-bye.